Yes, good morning. Myself, Daneshwari Enula. Okay, so with respect to our last class, we had come across with this UML as an diagram and using UML as your language, we have come across to know that how a class diagram can be drawn there. Okay, so with respect to a class diagram, we have come across to know some basics regarding what's a class model, what's a class diagram. A class diagram always, a class, whenever you are representing a particular class, so it consists three different sections in it. Okay, one happens to be the class name, the second one happens to be the data types, that is the data members, and the third section of the rectangular box contains the member functions of that particular class there. Okay, so that was all. Then if at all you are showing across with any kind of a relationship between the classes, so at that time the relationship between any two classes is shown through a link there. Okay, link is nothing but a horizontal line which exists between any two classes there. Okay, so now here assume this is person is one class and one more class is called out as company. So this line says out that this class called out as person is linked with this class called out as company. Okay, I can call it as link there. Okay, and another I can call it as a sophisticated terminology for a link is association. Okay, I say that this particular class person is associated with this another class called out as company. Okay, now comes another terminology called out as what is the association name. Okay, how are these two classes connected to one another? So my association stands out for person works for a company. So works for is the association name through which this particular class is connected to another class here. Okay, now here my main heading which goes across is association end names. That is, we are talking regarding association end names. So association end names are nothing but how is this class connected with this particular class, in what role, or else what is the role which is played by this class towards the another class. So person as a class, what's the role played towards the company there? Okay, in a company, if persons are there, I call them as employee. So employee is an association end name which connects this class to this class called out as company. Okay, whereas and vice versa on the other side, on to the company side. Okay, so what is the association name through which another class is connected towards it? So this class is connected towards this particular class through this association name called out as employer. So I say that company as a company member, so if at all I am speaking, what is the role played out by a company is company are the hirers of these persons there. So I call them as employer. Okay, this is association name, these are association end names. Then comes here, these are called out as your cardinality, or else I call it across with another term called out as multiplicity. So what do you mean by this multiplicity? Multiplicity is shown by these values called out as either it can be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, so on, with the dot as operators, then it can be asterisk. Okay, asterisk stands out for many relationships. Okay, it stands out for many relationships. So it means that how it is read is, now here for this you can just see that onto the person side I have this asterisk, onto the company side I have it as 0 dot dot 1. So what do you mean by this? A company can have many number of employees, many. Okay, this is how this justification is done. Okay, on to the other side, a person can work for one company or else may not work for any company. So that is 0 dot dot 1 says that 0 is the minimum value which is expected of this particular class, and 1 is the max value which is expected of this particular class. Okay, a person can work for no company or else can work for at the maximum one company. Okay, I have examples here called out as employee, Joe Doe, Mary Brown, Jean Smith. Okay, so these are three employees now. How many employers are there? Two employers are there. There are two employees who are working in the same company name called out as Simplex, and Jean Smith is working in another company name called out as United Widgets. Okay, in the same way, this is one more example here. I have user as one particular class and director as one more class. Okay, you can find here self relationships. Okay, self relationship. So what is this? A user can be an owner also. Okay, and can be an authorized user also. I am speaking about user as a single terminology, but with two different roles here. Okay, so owner, that is one, and asterisk. So asterisk means that how I am relating these two. User can have multiple directories, but multiple directories are associated with a single owner. Okay, here authorized users can have access to multiple directories. Okay, multiple users, multiple directories. So it is asterisk and a asterisk. Okay, so then in the same way, self related to the same one. Okay, directory, it contents. Okay, directory, I have two relationship associated with it. One I call it as contents, and the one more is container. Okay, directory contents values there. So that is onto the other side, directory is acting as a container. So there can be zero directories, or else there can be at the maximum one directory. Okay, followed out with that, it has some contents within it. So this is regarding an example for association and name. Let us come across with one more next type of association, and that's called out as ordering. Okay, what do you mean by this ordering now? Okay, ordering, always keep it in mind that it's an inherent part of association. So now, like for example, you're working on your window, your screens there, on your desktop screens or anything. Okay, so you have screen and there are multiple windows which you have opened. So multiple windows is nothing but asterisk. Okay, screen is, one screen is there with you, but multiple windows are there. Okay, so which is visible to you? Only one window is visible at a time. Okay, the other windows are inactive. So what do we say? We say that screen and window lie under this association called it as ordered. So ordered says that one after the another. So it is something like when you close off the first very window which is visible to you on the screen, then comes the next window which happens to be active. Okay, till that time it will be passive, then it becomes active there. Okay, like this you have ordered windows there. It can be one window. Okay, then that window is closed or else minimized, then comes the next window which happens to be active there. Okay, visible on is the association which is lying between them. Okay, this is ordering. Okay, now one more type of association is bags and sequences there. Okay, one, there are these two terms goes hand in hand, but there's a very small difference between bags and sequence there. Okay, bags says that it is similar to these things only. Bag is nothing but I have collection of different objects of a same class into one respective bag there. Okay, bag is a collection of elements with duplicates allowed. In a bag, duplicates are allowed, whereas a sequence, okay, is an ordered collection of elements with duplicates allowed there. Okay, so that's nothing but wherein it says that it's an ordered sequence. Okay, a sequence as a term, whenever you are using, it's nothing but wherein I call it across as the collection of elements there. But keep in mind that is if I use ordered or as if I use sequence, okay, they are almost the same thing, but ultimately ordered as a term says that it does not allow duplicates. Okay, this does not allow duplicates, whereas sequence allows duplicates there. Okay, so this is one difference between ordered and sequencer. Okay, it is an example given here, itinerary and airport. Okay, you have multiple itineraries and multiple airports there. Okay, but these itineraries, okay, have sequenced airports there. Okay, sequenced airports are nothing but one after the another. You will be reaching first, if at all you are going from Hubli to Delhi, so you will first reach out Mumbai. Okay, so then through Mumbai you will join out with Delhi. So this is nothing but that's a sequence, okay, sequence of those airports which are existing there. Okay, so this is bags and sequences, and one more is ordering. Okay, so then comes across is one more little bit more defined term towards your association, and that's called out as association class. Okay, what do you mean by this association class? Whenever, now like for example, you feel that the association which is existing between the classes, you find it more very important or else more dependent one. So at that time you can yourself make it converted into an class there. Okay, and any association name which is converted into class is called out as association class there. Okay, so I have file, okay, and users. Okay, multiple files are viewed or else are accessed by multiple users there. Okay, I call an association existing between them as accessible by. Okay, this accessible by, if I just write it, it will be just an association there. But I find that until and unless you have access permissions to these files, a user cannot access this file there. So at that time, I feel that accessible by happens to be an important association which is existing between these two respective classes there. So that's why, what do? I call this one as a class. Okay, so whenever class as a term comes, always keep in mind class name should be there, data members, member functions and all those things. Okay, here I have my class name called out as accessible by, and this is a data member called out as access permission. Okay, so for this, keep in mind this association he has been drawn with a vertical line towards the association with a dotted line there. Okay, it's a dotted line which points towards the link which is existing between the association. Okay, so anything which is pointed like this towards the class, I call this one as an association class. Okay, so an example is here. Okay, this is my file name. Okay, this is my permission, read write, and these are users. Okay, so this is an example for your association class. Similarly, one more example is over here. I have user. Okay, I have workstation. Multiple users, multiple workstation. Users have authorization towards the workstation there. Okay, so wherein I have with authorization, I have priorities and privileges there. Okay, and a start session. Okay, so these authorizations, okay, lie or else has a major impact towards this directory. Okay, directory has an authorization. Okay, so towards that, it authorization is been connected across with only one directory, that's a home directory, and directory has multiple authorizations which are being given across by multiple users there. Okay, these are different authorizations, like priority is there, privileges are there. Okay, multiple authorizations are given there. So this is regarding your association class. Then comes is qualified association. Okay, so what is this qualified association? Whenever I am relating any two classes there, okay, so along with that particular class, I have an association end name which plays a very important role towards that particular class. So I call this one as your qualifier. Okay, so this is called out as your qualifier there. Bank has an account number, so this is one of the important unique identity of a bank towards the account there. Okay, so these qualifiers are shown through a vertical small box there, and I call it across with an name there. Okay, qualifier name, and towards I have 1 and 0.1 there. Okay, it says that bank has either 0 account or else it can be 1 account there. Okay, so this is one, this is a qualified one, whereas not qualified it says one bank with multiple accounts. Okay, so this is another example. So similarly, I have another example here called out as stock exchange and company. Okay, company can have multiple ticker symbols in a stock exchange. Onto the other sign, stock exchange can be related either to zero company or else towards the one company. This is a qualified one, and this is not qualified. Okay, wherein I cannot show it across as an association class and show it. Okay, so this is with your qualified association there. Okay, in my next class, I'll tell you regarding generalization and inheritance. Thank you.